Welcome back. All right, last video, we're going to leave you with a few tips on VoIP. First one, if you have a cloud or hosted solution and you can't reach it with QSIS, try enabling stun. Then ask the provider if the domain is needed. The username may not be unique and isn't always equal to the authentication ID. Certainly in Call Manager, it is not. All right, next one. In Cisco Call Manager, there's something called a media termination point. Technically, it's no longer required, but not in all cases. There are a few edge cases where enabling it will get it working again. In Cisco Call Manager, there's actually two different ways that you can set up a third-party SIP device, basic and advanced. With basic, you're only enabling one extension. So if you're using multiple soft phones within a single core, you would have to use advanced, which allows up to 8 soft phones. If you need more than 8, you would actually use a SIP trunk, which allows for unlimited soft phones. When you're troubleshooting, take a look at the SIP traffic. This will show us which device is sending the cancel or buy messages. And once you know which device is stopping or preventing the call, we want to know why. Usually, if the device is sending a buy message mid-call for no reason, it will give you an error code. Feel free to do a search online for that code. And if all else fails and you can't find the code or you can't figure it out, you should contact your administrator of that device or system to help you understand the why. In most cases, it's the fault of some configuration on their side. But at least we can get the customer pointed in the right direction, whether it's on our side or theirs. Enable soft phone event logging if you want to do data gathering for troubleshooting. Recall that if you enable logging within the soft phone, you're going to log all of the SIP traffic. You're not getting any audio. Use this URL to find out, http://, then your core's IP address, /sip.txt. It's going to look like a plain text website that shows all of your SIP logs. Then, if you want to get the network capture, go to http://, then your core's IP address, /pcap_capture.html. Make sure the packet length is set to 1600. Our engineers thought it would be useful for customers to be able to define that for themselves. But in most cases, that just caused problems because people would leave that blank, in which case they're capturing packets of length 0, which means that you're basically capturing nothing. You may need a successful call versus an unsuccessful call explained in detail. Then you can extract the logs as well. You can also extract the system logs because there's SIP information in there too. These are good tools that you can use for yourself just to look at the SIP traffic and find out what's going on. All right, we made it to the end. Thanks for watching and we'll see you next time.